In this day and age, your favorite device, be it a mobile phone, a laptop, or anything else, is chock full of personal data. Sensitive files, private messages, financial info, and even browser history, those things are a prime target for all kinds of malware. But worrying about dangers is not going to help. Instead, I'm going to share with you the best anti-malware tools, so you're going to learn both how to use them and what to do to never worry about malware again. And in each applicable case, I'll be including the best coupon codes in the description below in case you want to get everything you need with a discount. Let's do it. All right, first you need to know how to recognize early signs of malware infection. There are a few broad categories of danger signs, with the most widespread being unusual network activities. Now, not all of those signs are equal, and one or two of those are not too surprising on their own, but if you get random pop-ups despite being offline, your mobile data is skyrocketing for no reason, and websites you visit are being very cautious of you, well, let's just say this is obviously suspicious. Performance and system issues can become huge signs of trouble as well. Now, whether it's system slowdowns, rapid spikes in CPU usage, or random OS crashes, such as the blue or even black screen of death, you could also encounter rapid battery drain or apps opening and closing on their own. Neither of those things is normal. Now, a combination of those factors can be a sure sign of something being wrong with your device. And while it's not always malware's fault, it's better to be safe than sorry. And just try anti-malware tools in any case. So how to remove malware from my device is the next question that I need to answer. The obvious solution here is to use antivirus software. There's a good reason why anti-malware software has been around for decades, and long-standing providers like TotalAV, Norton, or Bitdefender are a safe pick if you want a reliable, time-proven solution that's guaranteed to show results. So let's say you've grabbed one of those antivirus options and now have an app open on your device. From here onwards, navigate to the scan page. If you're confused, look at the screen and take a pause if you need to. Here is how to get to the scan page in the TotalAV, Norton, and Bitdefender apps. Okay, and now for mobile users, here's TotalAV, Norton, and once again, Bitdefender. So I recommend starting off with a full system scan, okay? This option takes the longest, but also performs the deepest check of all the files and apps on your device. According to independent researchers, these antiviruses have some of the highest detection rates in the industry, and in my tests, they showed me they can remove the virus threats without any issues. Notably, each of those apps also offers real-time protection that filters out suspicious activity. VPN for online protection, and password management for all-around security coverage. In my opinion, TotalAV stands out as a great option for beginners with a very user-friendly pricing. Now, Norton is a bit better if you know what you're doing, as it has a lot of in-depth customization options, and Bitdefender is a bit in between, both with user-friendly UI for beginners and plenty of customization for adept users. Regardless of which option you pick, you can check the links in the description or just scan these QR codes to get your preferred antivirus with a discount. All right, now, while antivirus protection is a sure way to get rid of malware, this is not the only step that you can take to ensure security of your devices. You can also try weeding out suspicious apps and programs yourself. So what are those apps? Well, try checking for apps that consume too much battery, use a lot of CPU, or just like appear by themselves, and you never installed them. Yeah, red flag. Amongst them, you can potentially find malicious apps with embedded malware. Now, while this can often work, if the malware in question has admin privileges, it'll be able to hide deeper in the system, hiding itself.
Yeah.
Now, additionally, if you have issues not from app-based malware, but from browser-based issues, malicious websites could host keyloggers, data scrapers, or even tracking code. So there are times when clearing cache, resetting browser settings, and such could help. Now, finally, if you're sure that the problem is external, you can try safeguarding your system by changing your passwords and updating your OS to the latest version. That said, this is something more that you would do to prevent malware infestation, not fix it. Talking about prevention methods, here are a couple more. So first, I recommend using a good antivirus with strong protection measures. Those not only come with malware scans, but also real-time protection. As I mentioned before, RTP tracks new files, running apps, and even online activity, detecting malicious elements and squashing them before they have a chance to ruin your day. Besides that, you need to keep your system and apps updated. app vulnerabilities are often exploited to infect devices with malware, and the latest updates often cover for weaknesses. But remember to be careful. The signs I mentioned in the beginning can reappear, in which case the early response is the best way to prevent long-lasting consequences. So you need to be vigilant about your online threats to limit your device's exposure to malicious elements, especially if you don't have an antivirus. This means not clicking on suspicious links, downloading software only from official sources, and so on. Now, to be honest, a good antivirus covers all of those manual steps to the point that I become a bit used to letting TotalAV do all the prophylactics for me. Yeah, I know it's kind of lazy, but I got used to the convenience. So if you want to save time and automatically prevent all malware infections, as well as remove existing threats, consider just getting one of the best antivirus 2025 options like TotalAV, Norton, or Bitdefender. You can get the best deals for these providers through the link in the description. Now, while you're there, remember to leave a like and subscribe for more cybersecurity updates, and I'll see you soon in another video. Stay safe.